Hello and welcome to INBCN News. You are watching English Bulletin with me, Ratnakar. News in detail. Former President Pranab Mukherjee passes away at 84. He had earlier this month undergone brain surgery at the Army Research and Referral Hospital in the national capital. Earlier on Monday, his condition deteriorated further and he was in a state of septic shock due to a lung infection. Former President of Bharat Ratna Pranab Mukherjee passed away Monday. He was 84. Mukherjee had earlier this month undergone brain surgery at the Army Research and Referral Hospital in the national capital. Earlier today, hospital authorities said his condition deteriorated further and he was in a state of septic shock due to a lung infection. His death was announced by his son Abhijit Mukherjee. Ganeshpet police nabbed VCS thief here on Monday. As per the report, Mr. Yash Paliwala went to State Bank of India Mahal branch to deposit some amount when the thief picked his pocket and ran away with the wallet. Mr. Paliwala marked his complaint with Ganeshpet police station on the same day. According to the police sources, Mr. Paliwala briefed the personality of the thief and his put ons and also identified his vehicle. Searching on these clues, Ganeshpet police searched the thief with its secret sources, caught Mayur Kayarkar and interrogated him. Mayur Kayarkar admitted the crime and also accepted his previous crime events in front of the police. It is also known that Mayur has already having cases registered at various police stations under Section 420. Till now, Ganeshpet police investigating further in this matter. As the Ganesh festival at its end and all the Ganesh works are going to adieu Ganesha, NMC has nominated 14% across 10 zones for overseeing deployment of mobile emergent tanks. Citizens can call the persons in case they have any difficulties in emerging of idols at their homes. Respective assistance commissioner have been made in charge for their zones. Special emergent rath also arranged for the purpose and can be called on if no other arrangement is available. The rath will be provided on availability basis. Due to COVID-19 pandemic, from the point of safety of citizens, the civic body is limiting the number of artificial tanks that used to be placed at various squares across the city. Therefore, NMC has appealed to citizens to go for low-key celebration at their respective home and places and emerge idol at home. But in case citizens do not have any emergent facility at home, for them, NMC has deployed mobile tanks that would be available on call. This year, emergent at all lakes and public water bodies to its banned. Due to heavy rains in and around Madhya Pradesh and Vidarbha region in the last few days, all the 16 doors of Pench River located at Parshivni Tehsil were opened by 6 meters. After 10 days of the flood-like situation, still all the 16 gates of this dam are opened by 0.5 meters. All the nearby villages on the bank of the Pench and Kanan River affected due to the heavy discharge of the water from this dam. Especially in Parshivni district, bridges washed out due to this flood and disconnect the avenue joining Parshivni and Ramtek Tehsil. The flow of the river also affected the farmers as most of the fields were filled with flood water, ruined cotton farming. As per the new guideline issued by the state government, e-pass is now not necessary for moving between two cities in the state. The rule will be made effective from 2nd of September. Under the Mission Begin Again, state government issued new guideline and more relaxation on Monday. As per the new guidelines, government offices and MMR sectors will remain open with a 30% manpower capacity. While in other sector in Maharashtra, all the government offices will be operational with a 50% manpower. Hotels and lodges will be operational with full swing. For the public transportation, private buses, minibuses and other transporters will be permitted. The separate guideline for this will be issued by Transport Commissioner. The COVID-19 pandemic continues to spread in Nagpur as the district witnessed 1,227 new corona positive cases on Monday. With this, the cumulative number reached to 29,555. An incline in the number of deaths was reported today with 34 patients succumbing to the infection. The total fatality count has now gone up to 1,045. The number of recovered patients was also seen today as 1,223 patients got discharged in the day, taking the tally of recovered cases to 19,244. The current affected patients are 9,266, including 5,812 are from home isolation. The recovery rate of Nagpur has reached to 65.11%. Well, that's all from this bulletin. For more updates in and around the city, stay tuned with INBCN News. Till then, Ratnagar says goodbye. Please do take good care of yourself.